morning, children. So I'm here again with a very important concept from your lesson, metals and non-metals. In my previous video, we saw about the amphoteric oxides, right? So now it is the turn of metal reactivity series. Already I talked about this in the chemical reactions of metals and non-metals. But once again, let's have a look at how you can remember this series, because it's very important to know how these metals are extracted or how these metals react, because it ultimately depends upon their reactivity. How reactive a metal particularly is gives you what different reactions it can involve in, right? So you can understand by this is the metal reactivity series. If you go from top to bottom, the metal reactivity decreases. That means the metals which are there on the top are more reactive than the ones which are below them. You can see over here, this is the metal reactivity series, and here there is a non-metal reactivity series also. Don't simply think that only metals have a reactivity series. We have not learned about the non-metal reactivity series till now, but you have to know that also, because ultimately the way these non-metals react also depends upon, you know, their reactivity, how strong or how reactive a particular non-metal is. Okay. We'll first go with the metal reactivity series. Here are these elements. You can see potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium. And after aluminium, you'll have carbon actually, which is nothing but a non-metal, so I've not included it. Then zinc, iron, tin, lead. And then we have hydrogen over here. We have hydrogen here, this level. And then carbon, copper, silver, gold and platinum. So basically, metals can be classified into metals more reactive than hydrogen and metals lesser reactive than hydrogen. Usually it is classified in such way, children. We take hydrogen as a reference element and we can classify these metals into two categories actually. Metals which are more reactive than hydrogen and metals which are lesser reactive than hydrogen. So you can see all these metals which are on top, above the hydrogen, they all come under those that category of metals which are more reactive than hydrogen. And these four actually, copper, silver, gold and platinum, they are the metals which are lesser reactive than hydrogen. So you see that, you know, based on this only, you can see that the elements, these metals, they react and form corresponding products actually. So we have seen them in the displacement reaction, chemical displacement reaction. Have you seen that, children? These metals, they react with salt solutions and form different products. They displace the lesser reactive element from its compound and occupy its place, forming a new compound. That is nothing but metal react, what you call chemical displacement reactions, right, children? That you have to remember all this. There is one simple mnemonic that I just got it from the net actually, which will help you remember the series, because one element here and there and you will completely lose it, because many times in the examination also it is asked frequent. It is one of the most frequently asked questions, children. Many a times it has been asked in the examination whether a reaction is possible or not. Sometimes they give a lesser reactive element along with a very strong metals salt solution, and they ask you whether there will be any reaction happening or not. You should say no, because depending upon their level or their position in this metal reactivity series only, if it is higher, if it is at a position higher or above a particular element, then it is more reactive than that element. So you can, so let's see an example. Like iron sulfate, when it is dipped, when a copper nail, copper coin or metal is dipped in iron sulfate solution, can reaction happen? Now you have to see what are the two elements that are present, metals that are present over here. One is copper, another one is iron. Now check in this metal reactivity series. Where is copper? Here is the copper. And where is iron? Somewhere up over here, iron. So what do you mean? Iron is more reactive here. Iron is more reactive than copper. So can copper now displace iron from its compound? No. So the reaction will not happen, because copper is lesser reactive than iron sulfate. Got it, children? So in that manner, you have to check the positions of these various metals which are present in the metal series, and then you have to decide whether a reaction is possible or not. If I say iron plus iron sulfate plus magnesium, for example, somewhere over here and magnesium is here, yes, there can be a reaction. If I write zinc here, can it happen, children? Zinc, iron sulfate plus zinc. Yes, it can happen because zinc is more reactive than iron. So what you get is nothing but zinc sulfate plus iron will be displaced out. So in order to solve such reactions, in order to complete such reactions, you have to have an idea of metal reactivity series. I got a mnemonic, actually, the way you can remember this metal reactivity series in a better manner. So simply, you see, pink smiling cats meow at zebras in the long curly swirly grass. Do just revise this, you know, 3 or 4 times or 4 or 5 times. Then you will remember the starting letter actually represents the name of the element here. P stands for potassium, S for sodium and so on. C, A for calcium, M for magnesium, like that. You can remember. What is that? It's such a cool thing, right? Pink smiling cats meow at zebras in the long, long means L means lead, curly swirly grass. So in that way you can remember, hopefully, attempt such questions if they are asked in the examination. Okay, very important, children, because based on this only the metal extraction also is done. That means different procedures are employed in order to extract metals of different reactivity. So you need to have very, very importantly this idea. Okay. Now coming to the non-metal reactivity series also. Here also you have like fluorine, chlorine, oxygen, bromine, iodine, sulfur and phosphorus. When you go from top to bottom, here also the reactivity decreases. Fluorine being the most reactive non-metal. So any reaction which is like any displacement reaction, sometimes, you know, even here also similar reactions take place, and based on their reactions, whether they displace the other non-metal or not, it is decided. Okay, so that is about the metal and non-metal reactivity series. Please do copy down these two in your classwork. Please copy down in your classwork and learn well along with some examples also, children. Okay.